All right. Good afternoon, April. How are you today?
Good afternoon. I'm good. And yourself?
I am doing fantastic. So I've got your resume here in front of me. We've been chatting off film in regards to your career goals and what you're looking for. But in order to get where we're going, we've got to know where you came from. So tell me a little bit about your background to get started. Let's start with your military background.
Okay. So I served in the military for 26 years. I came in as an E1 and I retired as an E8. When I retired, I was a command senior enlisted leader. So we had about 500 people that we were responsible for in five different medical clinics in
Okay.
five different geographical locations. So that's my military background.
Fantastic. So post-military, what did you do right after you got out of the army?
So actually, I was Navy,
Oh,
and
I'm so sorry, April.
you're fine. You're fine. They get us mixed up a lot. So once I got out the military, actually right before I got out, I did a skill bridge internship with JLL, and it
Great.
was remotely, and it was for facility coordinator and facility management. So that's what I did, right prior to me getting out. They allow up to 180 days for internship.
Fantastic. So tell me a little bit about that internship. What did a typical day look like for you in that role?
So typical day is you start at 8 o'clock a.m. and you're done by 4:30 p.m. You do work with different coasts. So sometimes you will be, on a the Pacific timeline or either Central, whichever company you're working with. Everything was done remotely, and we did Microsoft Teams meetings, a lot of them. But it was very insightful, and it gave me a different perspective on working remotely because we got a lot done. We got a lot done, and mainly you was responsible for, you was a direct liaison between my boss and the companies that we was representing as far as managing their HVAC systems or managing their project sites or managing their monthly, whatever that company may have affiliate with JLL.
Fantastic. Now, after your internship, what did you do next?
After my internship, I kind of said, okay, I'm gonna take a little break. I've been doing this 26 years nonstop. I was like, I think I deserve a little small break. So that's what I've been doing, and just kind of looking around for what I want to do when I grow up. So that's the stage I'm at now. Of course, I got bored really quickly because I got so used to doing and every day. So I wanted to get out into the corporate world, to see what it's like.
Fantastic. Now, I want to go back to here on your resume to your director of development that you were actually doing in the Navy. Tell me a little bit about that role.
So basically, that role was primarily specifically geared towards the medical aspect of the military. We
Okay.
developed, basically, we did development for the sailors as far as prior to them going to their operational command. We prepared them from BLS perspective. We trained them. It was actually pretty much twice a week for training, to get them ready for field exercises if they got assigned to the Marine Corps, or for the ship if they got assigned to the ship. And then we provide day-to-day operations for the United States Naval Academy. So we were with the midshipmen. It was a 24-hour, hour day job. So make sure I assign the right people to the right platoon, the right unit. But it was great. It was absolutely amazing training people to be prepared at any moment's notice, whether it was war or if it was a humanitarian assignment.
Now, obviously, dealing with people, there is still a level of administrative personnel files, a lot of paperwork that I'm sure you have to keep up with. Tell me a little bit about some of the organizational skills that were involved with that position.
So a lot of the organization skills, actually, I had an assistant, an executive assistant. She was amazing. If it wasn't for her, I'm pretty sure I would probably been everywhere. But for the most part, we had different files that we was responsible for. We kept them. Of course, you have to have a code and everything to get into those files when you're working in that position. However, we had our lot spaces was locked. You had to have access to get into them. And you would have each file was labeled. You know what specific file was where, who it belonged to, and only those that needed to know where those files were.
Now, are you when you are so you said you had an executive assistant, but are you still putting in the information to the data of these files based on absolutely the conversations
that you're having? Right. So normally what happens is, say if it's an evaluation or a performance appraisal, I would do it as a supervisor or immediate supervisor, the information, and I will upload it. What the executive assistant did is prepared it for our board meeting. So she would make sure that it was prepared and ready to go for the actual board meeting. Or if we was doing interviews, we would do all the preliminary work first and get it to her. She would have it set up. So when it's time to do the interview, we have all the necessary, you know, pieces of information for that interview.
Okay, awesome. Now, we were talking also too off camera in regards to other computer softwares that were not proprietary to the military that you were comfortable with. Tell us a little bit about those.
So let's say, so we use Excel. Excel is pretty much everywhere. We did, what is the word I'm looking for? PowerPoint. But a lot of other programs that we use is like, say, DFAS, if it was dealing with accounting or if it was dealing with personnel. We also utilize, of course, My Pay when you're dealing with military pay. And then once I got into the SkillBridge internship with JL, we use other different softwares that was specific geared towards JLL. And it was easy to maneuver because you had a human resource portion in there where you have to go in to sign in and sign out. You have different training documents that you have to be responsible for. So those are just some of the systems that we, you know, we use.
Now, for folks that are not familiar with what JLL does, tell us a little bit about that company, because I think that's a huge selling point to this corporate organization that you got, you had the opportunity to this internship with.
So Jones Lang and LaSalle is the company that I got to do a SkillBridge internship for up to 180 days. And primarily it deals with like corporate and commercial real estate companies. And we're responsible for managing those companies and making sure they have all the equipment and supplies they need for their company to run. We manage their budgets. Myself and another facility coordinator worked together. So, and we had meetings with the company executives, the CEOs, CCOs, and you get, you're also, you know, pretty much they like to tap into what you're really good at. So, you get into the reporting piece, which, you know, I think I was pretty good at that, but for the most part, working with JL, I learned a lot about corporate and commercial real estate and how to manage a facility, how to network with the company itself, and then network with the people who may be coming in to do, let's just say, a maintenance call on an HVAC system or something like that. So you are facilitating all of that. You're communicating with the maintenance people that's going to come in and do the work for the company, and you're going to communicate with the actually facility manager to know, and you put it into the system. Corrigo, which is another system, you put it into that system for them to know, okay, this is a work order that's going in, this is who's going to be doing the work order, and the person who does it, they will go in and accept it. They accept the work order, and you just make a note showing that they accept it. And then sometimes they may say, okay, hey, we can't fix it because we need a part. So they will put their notes into the system because you normally have a timeline when it needs to be fixed. It's kind of like preventative maintenance or either just regular maintenance.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Fantastic. I love that. April, if you weren't sitting with me here right now and I was chatting with maybe a coworker or past colleague of yours, how do you think they would describe your work ethic?
Oh, wow. So I have many colleagues. So they probably would say she's funny. She's a team player. She's firm. But yet she is open to pretty much, I'm open to a lot of decisions because my way may not be the best way to get things done. I'm open to change. I'm a morning person, so I get up happy and I get the job done. Most times, you know, I like to have a plan. I like to communicate with the team and management, and we come up with a plan to get it done. Yeah.
I love it. April, at this stage in your career, what's the most important thing to you about the next company that you work for?
The most important thing about the next company is to bring my experience that I've had to the military, to this company, be a team player, and just enjoy life. You know what I mean? Enjoy working with different people because this is different for me. You know, I'm coming from a more disciplined work center, and I will be going to more of a civilian workspace. And it's a lot of people that's been prior military, so you have stories that you can share. So I really want to go just to continue to grow, because I still want to continue to be into the workforce. And I want to have a, you know, be an asset to other people that's retiring or getting out. And I can say, hey, this is a company that I work for. Won't you consider applying for this company? They're great. These are the benefits. And, you know, being that mentor, still having that mentorship guidance to the military as well as the company I'm with.
I love that. And Abel, and I really do love your background as a whole. You know, anytime folks come to me looking for their next civilian career after the military, there's always a couple of key things I look for on, you know, their background and their experience and their resume. A lot of what you have done is the leadership side, the people side. So is it HR? No. But are there a lot of correlations? Absolutely. But there's also a lot of project management, and I can see that's what you've been doing. And then I love the internship at JLL. It's a very large customer of ours. That's why I wanted you to kind of tell what your internship looked like, because they are just phenomenal. And any type of exposure to their processes is a huge selling point for other organizations, because there's a reason why they're the biggest in their industry. They're good at what they do.
Exactly.
So I love that. And April, I'm going to go ahead and stop the recording and chat with you a little bit more if that sounds good. But thank you so much for sharing, you know, your background with us this afternoon.
Thank you.